participating this evening, and thank you for inviting me to participate in the third annual Worcester Educational Development Foundation Gala celebrating the arts in your local public schools. It's a particular joy for me to be here because your efforts and concerns are so close to my heart and all the things that I believe in. The importance of the arts and self-expression among our youth. I'd like to paraphrase something that the wonderful author Catherine Ann Porter says. I won't quote her exactly, but she says in essence that the arts have continuously and literally by faith, that they are, the arts live continuously, I beg your pardon, and literally by faith, they outlive even the civilizations that created them, and they are what we find when the ruins are all cleared away. I think they mirror what we are, they tell us all about ourselves, but all about us is lying in the ashes, and I think that's a wonderful quote. I've been told that the young people participating tonight have studied and diligently prepared an outstanding evening of classical, popular, and entertaining selections for us all to enjoy, I can't wait. As we gather to shine a spotlight on them, I am in awe of the beauty and elegance of your community. And I understand that the Mechanics Hall has hosted concerts and performances since before the Civil War, and that the continuity of sounds that have emanated from here have been lovingly embraced from generation to generation, and from home to home. Bravo. Attend the same schools that their parents and grandparents studied, that this is a community that celebrates the diversity of its neighborhoods and the accomplishments of its citizens, young and old. And I applaud you all for demonstrating to these young people performing tonight and to all the young people in the audience that the arts count. They really matter. They can bring together and make it stronger, and as I say, they define who we are. I wish I have to highlight the efforts of my new friends, Janet Matthew and Fran Arena, for their passion and their tenacity in making it possible for me to be here. I cannot tell you, they've been on the phone, they've been non-stop singing. I didn't know how happy I am to be here. They are the essence of the care and dedication of this wonderful community, and I ask you all to applaud them tonight as well. Finish by saying good luck to everybody here tonight. As I say, I can't wait to hear you, and thank you so much for letting me be here. Thank you.